Hey everyone, welcome back to our another episode of Exploring CA Profiles. And this episode is gonna be different because this is not only about the profile, but yeah, this about the CA in Dubai. So few days back, I just posted on Instagram that what are the questions which you want to ask from the CA in Dubai, and I have received a very good response on that. Okay, so in this episode, we are going to ask all those questions to one of my friend who is a working professional in Dubai and who is recently got married, and like still he is giving me time to take this interview. Thank you so much, Rahul, for that. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, Rahul, so my first question is, can you just give me a brief introduction? Like, when did you clear your CA finals? What other qualifications do you have apart from CA? And how did you decide that okay, you want to shift to Dubai, and everything about you, where do you belong, like that?
Thank you, Kavita. So I am Rahul Ranjan, a chartered accountant by profession. I cleared my chartered accountancy in November 2018. After that, I got a job in Dubai via LinkedIn. Apart from chartered accountancy, I did diploma in IFRS, because when I cleared my CA exams, IndAS was not in our syllabus, so, and I always wanted to work overseas. So I thought getting a diploma in IFRS will give me a little bit advantage to get a job in Middle East. I have total 4 years of experience working in Dubai. 3 years I was in financial accounting advisory services, where I was implementing IFRS standards like IFRS 9, IFRS 15, 16 and 17. And then from the last year, I shifted to a new company that is also a consulting firm. I am in the risk and compliance department. So currently I'm doing operational risk assessment for banks and some fraud risk assessment for insurance company.
Okay. So when did you shift it to Dubai? Like, as a fresher chartered accountant only you got the job in the Dubai, or like you have some working experience in India and then you got shifted?
No, I was only having articles of experience of 3 years, which we all CAs have. So I got a job there as a fresher. So just the next day of me clearing the chartered accountancy exam, I got a message on LinkedIn from one of my senior managers in that firm. Do you want to work in Dubai in IFRS? I told yes, and interview was done. And within 1 week, I got the job. Yeah, and this one is for the students, the CA final student who have multiple attempts. So I am also a multiple attempt chartered accountant. What I want to say is that always work hard, improve, keep working on your skills, and you will get a job. It's very easy to get a job if you have the right skill set. So me being a multiple attempt CA, I easily cracked all the interview and I got it.
That's so great to hear, and it's kind of a motivational too. Okay, so let's start with a chain of questions which students have asked to me. Okay, so their first question is, like, is there any campus placement program organized by ICI for generally for the aspirants who wants to work in Dubai? Because I guess our degree is applicable to Dubai also, right?
So I'm not sure of any campus placement specifically organized for Dubai, but I think our institute organizes some overseas campus placement. So I have never participated in that. I'm not sure, but for those students who want to work overseas, the best way to get a job is via referral. Build your connections on LinkedIn. Do networking, a lot of network. Send cold emails, text messages. Build your network, and then I think you may land up a job in overseas. This is the best way. The second way is to apply in the career job websites. Like, you have in Middle East, you have Gulf Jobs, you have Naukri Gulf. Apply on those websites, and you have to keep on applying, because it's not sitting in India and getting a job overseas is not that easy. So you have to keep on applying, build your network, and you will land it. If you have the right skill set, the skills which recruiters want, if you have it, you will land a job.
Okay. So that means, like, while being in India, like while staying in India also, we can start to apply and we can give the interviews, and after clearing the interview, we can move to Dubai, right? Like, we don't need to go to that country and then find the jobs.
Third way, yeah, definitely. If someone is able to travel to Dubai, because it's a costly thing, you need to be there for at least a month, and there will be some expenses. So if you're ready to invest that much time and money, then yeah, the probability of getting a job in Dubai is much higher if you are in Dubai and you're looking for a job. But that is a bit costly. So because many students, those who are freshers, will not be able to invest that much amount. So it's better to build your connections in India and start applying.
Okay, so my next question is, what are the profiles available for Indian CAs there? Like auditing. Auditing must be different, I guess, because in India, auditing happens with our laws. So how different is that? And what are the other profiles available, like taxation or IFRS, you have said?
Profiles for Indian CAs are if you are in Big Fours, there will be audit profiles, statutory audit, internal audits. Then UAE also introduced value-added tax in, I think, November in 2018 or 17 it got introduced. So there is a lot of opportunities in indirect taxation VAT. Now they are also introducing corporate tax. So there are a lot of opportunities now in corporate tax and international taxation because Saudi, they also have corporate tax from many years. So now they're the companies in Dubai, they have a lot of transactions across the Middle East. So those countries which have a corporate tax, there will be a lot of transfer pricing things, which there are a lot of opportunities in transfer pricing right now.
So this is about the CAs in job. Let's say like a CA wants to build a practice in Dubai. So is it possible?
Practice, yes. There are a lot of CA firms, a lot of chartered accountants who are practicing. They have their firms, and there are a lot of small firms, CAs, who are doing practice.
So my next question is like, what is the average package a CA fresher can get?
So if you are in a Big Four, you can get something around 10,000 dirhams to 11,000 dirhams as an associate consultant or a consultant. So it all depends on your skills and negotiation. So if someone is getting 10,000, there will be CAs who might be getting 5,000, 7,000 also. So it all depends based on your qualification, based on how you gave the interview. So there is no right or wrong answer for this. So something around 7 to 11,000 CA fresher can get easily. Someone is getting less than that, then they should make sure that they are provided with accommodation by their company. If they are not provided accommodation and their salary is 5,000, then it's a bit difficult. Otherwise, 7 to 11,000 is what most of the fresher CAs get. I'm talking in dirhams, right? Monthly.
Right. Okay. Monthly. Okay. This is monthly. And how much is the average cost of living, like the rent expenses, food expenses for a bachelor and as well as for a settled person, like who are living individually?
So someone who is a bachelor, if they go for a shared accommodation, the cost of living will be less. Suppose 1500 dirhams, they can get a monthly a sharing accommodation, then maybe 1000 dirhams for food and traveling. So 2500 to 3000 is the average expense. It can be less also, it can be more also, depending on people to people. So 3000 dirhams for a bachelor.
Okay, and like someone who is not a bachelor who wants to get settled in Dubai, then what?
Maybe 6 to 7,000 also, or it may be more depending on which location you are staying. If you are staying in a near metro, if you are having a 1 BHK, it will the rent the cost will go up. It all depends on your lifestyle. So, but someone who is settled, they can manage with 6 to 7,000 dirhams per month.
So how much we can save on an average in Indian rupees, like monthly, how much we can save
It
there?
all depends on your package. If someone's salary is 10,000 dirhams and their expenditure is 50%, 5,000, they can save 5,000 dirhams, which is equivalent to right now the exchange rate is 22. So 5,000 into 22, something around 1,10,000, 20,000.
Okay. So anyways, it's like better than doing job in India. Okay, and how is the monetary growth in long run? Like how is the increment percentage on an average? Like you can say a range, or if you want to switch from one company to another company, then how is the average hike you can get?
See, many people I've heard, including me, I will say, you can expect 100% growth if you are switching. Again, I will say, not everyone will get that. It depends on the way you negotiate, the way you give your interview. It depends on person to person. So there is no average rate. Some people get 50. If you are not able to give your interview well or not able to negotiate, you will end up getting 25%, 20%. So, but there is a lot of growth opportunities in Dubai. You can easily get 100% growth also.
Okay, and like if you're staying in the same company, then how about the increment, promotions and all?
Again, depends on the performance, how you are performing. So it can range up to 20-25%. If you are not perform well, maybe 10%. Depending on what package you are. If your salary is low, then the percentage will be more. Like if your salary is 7,000, 8,000, then 20-25% or 40, even 40% they give. If your salary is less, but if your salary is maybe more, then 15-20%. So again, it's very subjective, you know. It depends on person to person, the way you are performing. If you are performing well, then definitely you don't have to worry about money in Dubai.
Okay. So my next question is like, how is the work culture there? How it is different from India, and how do you feel like being there? How is the food and all these things?
So the work culture is very good. I have not faced any problem in my last 4 years. I'm traveling to other GCC countries like Bahrain, Qatar, Saudi. The work culture is very good everywhere. I have never faced any problem as of now. There are a lot of Indian CAs who are working there. We have a Dubai chapter also, so which organizes a lot of CPE events, which happens almost on a regular basis. So the work culture is good. The food, if you are you get all kinds of Indian food in Dubai, you will not face any problem. Whether you are a Gujarati, Marwari, Rajasthani, you get everything. Punjabi, Kerala, you get there are people from all the different parts of India. Okay, and there are places where you will only find Indians.
Okay, that's great. Like, you don't miss the Indian touch there.
Yeah, you don't miss the Indian touch, you don't miss the Indian food.
So, how to apply a job in Dubai? Like, you have already said that via LinkedIn or like via Telegram groups you can. But like, is there anything from where we can get to know, okay, this company is having vacancy, so we can apply there?
No, I don't think there is any such thing. If there is any vacancy, that will be posted on LinkedIn. So on LinkedIn, you can just go to the search criteria and put a filter in the country, Dubai, then you will get all the jobs which are there. This is one of the way in which you can, because most of the companies post their jobs in LinkedIn also. So you can apply from there. If you see any job from XYZ company, then start connecting with the people in that company on LinkedIn. Send your CV to them on LinkedIn and send your CV to the hiring manager if you are able to find the name of the hiring manager or to the HR of the company. So these are some of the ways in which you can send your CV across the right person. There is no particular website, I will say, where you can get to know. Yeah, so there is only the other way I told, build connections.
So my last question is like, how is the opportunity if someone wants to come back? Let's say, okay, you have spent 5 years or 10 years in Dubai and now you want to come back to India.
So for that, Kavita, it depends on which profile you are working. If someone is working in UAE VAT, okay, that is different from Indian GST. So it will be a little bit challenge for them to adopt GST. But if you are working in internal audit, if you are working in risk and compliance, if you are doing operational risk for banks or fraud risk assessment or the profiles which do not require a knowledge of Indian laws, so then it will be very easy to come back to India and start a job here. But if you are working in corporate taxation, say, then again you will have to learn the Indian income tax. So there will be some efforts required to transition.
Okay, so I guess like I have asked most of the commonly asked questions to you, and thank you so much for attending this session. Like, even though you are so busy with your marriage rituals, if I have left anything, then I'll provide Rahul's LinkedIn ID in the description box, and you can definitely message him, and Rahul will be so happy to guide you further and answer you. And you can even send your CV to him.
Thank you, Kavita, for inviting me to your show.
Okay, guys, so let's end this video here, and please subscribe for more such useful content. Thanks for watching.